It was unbelievably quick. He was absolutely fine. He came home from a concert. He'd gone to Wembley to see the Pink Floyd in concert. He came home, he had his Sunday dinner, he ate a full roast dinner, didn't say he felt poorly. We had friends over, we chatted in the afternoon, said he needed pots and pans for university because he just got amazing grades to go to Warwick University. He was on the front page of the Times with his academic results, and he was so happy.
And then suddenly started feeling
6:30
unwell.
In the evening, he phoned me, as he would. He was in his room, he phoned me, and he just said, "Mum, I feel cold, can I have something hot to eat?" And I took him cheese on toast. We went down there, Mark, my husband, was there, and he said his feet felt cold, and we gave him his slippers and we put the heating on. And the next thing we knew was at 11:30 at night, he had a headache. I went in and gave him some paracetamol. And he said, "Mum, I just need to get to sleep." And I said, "Yes, you do. You just need to get to sleep." 2:30, he rang me. He said he felt sick. I gave him a bowl and he was sick. I said, "What did you eat at the concert?" And he said, "A dodgy chicken kebab."
And then eventually you got a doctor out. He went to hospital, but the end came horribly quickly.
Called the doctor at 4:30. He was rushed to hospital. He got to hospital at 7:20 in the morning, dead by 10 o'clock.
Absolutely devastating for you.
Unbelievable. Mm. Unbelievable.
Did you know anything about this meningitis W when it happened? Had you ever even heard of it?
No, never heard of it. I didn't know the symptoms. I thought the signs were things like a rash, bright light. He had none of that. He didn't have the rash. Cold feet is a real, cold hands and cold feet, I think, is a real symptom that needs to be pushed. But the speed is so quick, I'm glad they're bringing a vaccine
Indeed.
In. It was unbelievably quick. He was absolutely fine. He came home from a concert. He'd gone to Wembley to see the Pink Floyd in concert. He came home, he had his Sunday dinner, he ate a full roast dinner, didn't say he felt poorly. We had friends over, we chatted in the afternoon, said he needed pots and pans for university because he just got amazing grades to go to Warwick University. He was on the front page of the Times with his academic results, and he was so happy.
And then suddenly started feeling
6:30 in the evening, he phoned me, as he would. He was in his room, he phoned me, and he just said, "Mum, I feel cold, can I have something hot to eat?" And I took him cheese on toast. We went down there, Mark, my husband, was there, and he said his feet felt cold, and we gave him his slippers and we put the heating on. And the next thing we knew was at 11:30 at night, he had a headache. I went in and gave him some paracetamol. And he said, "Mum, I just need to get to sleep." And I said, "Yes, you do. You just need to get to sleep." 2:30, he rang me. He said he felt sick. I gave him a bowl and he was sick. I said, "What did you eat at the concert?" And he said, "A dodgy chicken kebab."
And then eventually you got a doctor out. He went to hospital, but the end came horribly quickly.
Called the doctor at 4:30. He was rushed to hospital. He got to hospital at 7:20 in the morning, dead by 10 o'clock.
Absolutely devastating for you.
Unbelievable. Mm. Unbelievable.
Did you know anything about this meningitis W when it happened? Had you ever even heard of it?
No, never heard of it. I didn't know the symptoms. I thought the signs were things like a rash, bright light. He had none of that. He didn't have the rash. Cold feet is a real, cold hands and cold feet, I think, is a real symptom that needs to be pushed. But the speed is so quick, I'm glad they're bringing a vaccine
Indeed.
In.